guys, this is Marky from Affordatech, and today we have the Samsung Galaxy S20 Plus. Now, I've been using this phone for about 3 months now, and based on my personal usage, I'm gonna share with you the pros and cons of this phone. Now, here are the basic specs of the phone. Now, let's talk about the main feature ng phone nito, which is the 120Hz screen refresh rate na AMOLED screen niya. Now, the purpose of the screen refresh rate is for a buttery smooth scrolling experience. You can't see this in this video. You will appreciate it more when you're viewing it in real time. Now, the 120Hz screen refresh rate is somehow pleasing in the eye, pero yung pinaka-purpose lang niya is for a good scrolling or smooth scrolling when you view your browser or you're doing Facebook or viewing applications that support this feature. As mentioned by other users, including me, kapag nasanay ka na sa 120Hz na refresh rate, maninibago ka pagka gumamit ka ng phone na merong 60Hz lang na screen refresh rate. Now, let's take a look at the overall build of this phone. At the back, I installed the skin for this phone para protected siya from scratches. It's a big phone, but the weight is acceptable. Evenly distributed yung weight niya. And for its size, it's very comfortable to hold. The lower part of the phone, there's the USB Type-C and the speaker grill and a noise-canceling microphone. On the right side, we have the power button and volume rockers. On the top part of the phone, there's also a noise-canceling microphone and the micro SIM card tray na dual SIM. And on the side, it's very plain. No buttons, no nothing. It's a clean slate. So here are some sample photos with zoom. Just a note, wala siyang dedicated zoom lens. Unlike yung higher variant niya na S20 Ultra, meron yung dedicated zoom lens. Pero it's not an issue since mostly kapag nag-zoom ka na from 30 times onwards, medyo hindi na usable yung mga images. So if you're not into zooming or taking pictures up close, okay naman tong S20 Plus. Makakatipid ka pa since the higher variant na S20 Ultra is very expensive. Just like any other high-end flagship phone, ang camera niya is exceptional for a mobile device. And syempre, if you're just a casual user na hindi naman ganun kateki or very particular sa camera, it's more than enough for you. Especially when you're just doing point and shoot, may nakita ka dito, you take a snap. The photo mode and the scene optimizer is good enough for you if you like taking photos na point and shoot lang talaga. It does the job. My only gripe about this phone is the use of the Exynos 990 na chipset. Unlike sa other countries like the US, they're using the Snapdragon 865 na variant, which is I think a much superior na chipset compared sa Exynos 1. You're paying the same amount and you get only the lesser version of the product, which is not good. Especially here in the Philippines, mas mahal yung Samsung products dito, yung mga mobile phones compared to other countries. If you're not very particular sa local warranty, I would suggest you get the Snapdragon variant. This is due to the fact that the Snapdragon variant heats less, and when you're gaming for long periods of time, it tends to give a much consistent performance. Don't get me wrong, the Exynos variant is pretty good on its own. I just wish that Samsung used the Snapdragon version of the phone here in the Philippines, just like what they did in Korea and Hong Kong variant. Other than that, the Exynos variant can hold on its own. And as I've mentioned, if you're a casual user, hindi mo na mapapansin gaano yung difference ng Snapdragon and Exynos variant. I just hope that Samsung lessens the price of their mobile phones here in the Philippines kasi medyo expensive siya. For the past 3 months that I've been using this phone, I mostly prepare it over other phones that I have. Mainly because of the screen size when you're consuming media, when you're playing games, watching movies, and playing other media contents. Basta AMOLED display ng Samsung, you get the best of the best. The stereo speakers on this phone are pretty good. Not comparable to the ROG Phone 2 and 3, but they're pretty good. They can get loud depending on the quality of the audio. Now, when it comes to gaming, of course, this is a flagship phone. You would expect nothing less. You will not encounter any issues such as frame drops and lags unless your connection is unstable and the game is not optimized for the phone. While playing this game, Mobile Legends, I've noticed that the settings for ultra graphics is not enabled. So this is one example that the game is not yet optimized for the phone. But this is just a minor issue and can be resolved by future updates. Smooth and playable pa rin naman, no complaints there. When you're gaming for long periods of time, like 2 hours or more, it tends to heat up. Well, just like any other phone, when you're using it for prolonged periods of time, talagang mag-iinit siya compared to other phones with the similar hours of gameplay. Medyo mas mainit siya. Again, I think it has something to do with the processor. Other than that, the phone is perfectly fine. I would suggest that if you're playing for longer periods of time, just buy a mobile phone cooling fan and you're all set. Now, to wrap things up, is this phone solid? Affordable? Well, to tell you honestly, it's not. The official price of the Samsung Galaxy S20 Plus sa Philippines right now is around 49,990. Now, if this is expensive to you, then clearly you're not the target market. Now, if you're a person na nagtitipid and would love a phone with similar capability for a lesser price, and you're not very particular sa brand or you're a brand conscious, there are a lot of options out there like the Xiaomi Mi 10 5G, which is locally sold, and the currently for China only release na Mi 10 Ultra, which may soon be available as a global release. So the price of the S20 Plus and the S20 Ultra is quite expensive. Binabawi naman ni Samsung with regards to exceptional customer service and availability ng mga service center nila nationwide. Now, before we end this video, guys, if you'd liked it, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. Guys, the giveaway for the Xiaomi Mi AirDots is still ongoing. When the channel reaches 250 subscribers, we'll start away with the giveaway. The link of the video is down below in the description. Again, this is Marky, guys, and see you around. Bye-bye.